Speed of sound is related with pressure and density by that relation. If a medium has density rho and pressure is P, then speed of sound is denominated by C and it is represented by this vector, where R is the constant, P is the pressure, rho is the density of the medium in which sound is traveling, and C is the speed of sound. Scaling both sides, we get this relation. Now we have the definition of Mach number. Mach number is represented by capital M, or we can write it Q over C, where Q is the speed of flow and C is the speed of sound. Actually, Mach number is the ratio of speed of flow to the speed of sound, and it is denoted by capital M. Now our next topic is flow of a gas in converging pipe. If W be the area of cross section, W or omega be the area of cross section of a given pipe, and this DS is the length of this small shaded portion, this small shaded portion is taken under observation. This pipe will be converged if W decreases, meaning if area of cross section decreases, the flow of the gas will be increases. Means pipe is converging where area decreases. So we can write it as change in area with respect to that length decreases is less than or less than zero. So now we move further. DS is the small element, small shaded element length of converging pipe of that area that is under observation. As from equation of continuity, we know that product of rho, speed and cross section of area is constant. Area of cross section or speed is constant, and when fluid is compressible, as we are talking about the flow of gas, this means we will use equation of continuity for gases or for compressible fluid. And equation of continuity for compressible fluid is that the product of density, speed and area is constant at both end of the cross section. Now differentiate this equation with respect to s, small s. Differentiating this, firstly differentiate first term, second and third term will remain as it is. Next, differentiate second term, first and third term will remain as it is, plus differentiate third term and first and second term will remain as it is, and right hand side is constant, so its derivative is zero. Now divide this throughout equation by rho, q and omega. Then we will get 1 over rho d rho over ds plus 1 over q dq over ds plus 1 over omega d omega over ds is equal to 0. That is equation 1. This is the use of equation of continuity for gases. Now we use Bernoulli's theorem for compressible fluid that are gases, and gases expand adiabatically. That is the relation that we have already discussed some time before. R over R minus 1 P by rho plus half of Q square plus GH is equal to constant. Since height of fluid in pipe is same, pipe is converging. As from figure, it is clear that height of first end and last end are at the same surface. lower part of the pipe is at the same surface. No other is high, no other is low. So both are at the same height. Height is constant. So factor GH is also constant. So our this relation will become R over R minus 1 P by rho plus half Q square is equal to the constant. That is another constant, say C. As we are using expression of Bernoulli's theorem, when gas expanded adiabatically, then pressure and density relation for adiabatically expansion of gas is this. So we replace P by K rho power R. So this equation will become R over R minus 1 K rho power R over rho plus half of Q square is equal to C, and this rho will go into numerator and will come rho power R minus 1. Now as we are discussing this whole when we take a small element ds length under observation, so differentiate this complete equation with respect to s. When we differentiate this complete with respect to s, then here we apply product rule. R over R minus 1 is factor is here, and rho power R minus 1 factor is here. When we differentiate it, we will product rule use. First term as it is, derivative of rho power R minus 1 by using power rule. We are only differentiating density. R over R minus 1 is constant, K is constant.